Good morning, everyone, and thank you for tuning in. We welcome you to the NRI webinar special that we are hosting for you guys today. This is our 19th edition of our consumer education series, Niveshkar Befikar, presented to you by your trusted brand, PolicyBazaar.com. So everyone out here, we today are living in perhaps the most uncertain times. COVID-19 has torn apart families, robbed many of their jobs, and has left parents wondering what they can do for their children, for their loved ones, to at least secure the future financially. Children, as we all know, are the most precious assets we can have. And as parents, we want to give them the best of everything. So how about starting with the most valuable blessing, a good financial portfolio, a plan that ensures education, higher education, marriage, healthcare, and these several other things are taken care of well in advance. In short, ensuring your child is financially secure. I'm your host today for the session, Apeksha this side from PolicyBazaar.com, and we have our guest joining us, Vivek Jain, Head of Investments with PolicyBazaar, and Kushagra Ghai, Sales Head, NRI Investment Business. We're going to take you through some of the top child plans, top unit-linked child plans that you should consider to secure your child's future. And with that, welcome everyone onto the webinar. I'm inviting Vivek onto the dais here. Over to you, Vivek.
One of the questions that that people are asking is, I think we covered that in our presentation, because that if the child is say 1 year old, how should they go about investing and thinking about child plans?
The sooner you do it, the better it is, because the milestones of your child would not change if you plan to invest 5 years down the line or 3 years down the line. Your child would require money at specific points of ages, would not want to say a no to your child a couple of years down the line. So the sooner you do it, even if you are able to do it with a smaller amount, you are more than welcome, because that is the time which allows you to spread over accumulating that corpus for you and let your money grow. The longer you let your money grow, the higher you will be able to build a corpus.
There's a question from Abhinav, investing in Sukanya Samriddhi versus any child investment plan, what is better?
We have inquiries coming in from domestic customers at times about Sukanya Samriddhi, but we have seen a fair amount of conviction with regards to the WOP feature that the plans provide. So what happens is, one, you are able to get a higher rate of return at the time of growth. Throughout the period, to let your money grow, and the money that you would expect, or the growth rate that you would expect, is higher. What also we see is the waiver of premium concept, and the sum assured, 1% sum assured being paid as an income benefit, also is one of the unique features that customers have liked and have wanted to inquire more about.
There is a question from Mr. Kumar, who's asking that please recommend more options on life policy linked, unit linked plans like HDFC Life, Click to Wealth. What are the other options that are available?
If you visit our website, we have various options available in the child segment, from Bajaj Allianz, from Max Life, from even Edelweiss Tokyo and others. There are a lot of options with various unique selling points. Some of them have a triple benefit feature, some of them have 4-kick benefits, where one, at the time of death, the sum assured gets paid out. Two, you get an annual income or on a monthly mode, which is the 1% of your sum assured. Also, the waiver of premium gets kicked in, which means on your behalf, the company pays. In case of death in the plan from Edelweiss Tokyo, what happens is all upfront premiums get invested at the same time, which means if I, let's say I'm a father, and down the line 1 year I'm not there at the time of death, what would happen is the life cover, which is 10 times of my annual premium, gets paid. Some companies would invest every year at the time of my renewal date in the subsequent years, 2023, 24, 25, 26. However, in one of the plans from Edelweiss Tokyo, the company would upfront accumulate all premiums together and pump them into the market, allowing them more time to grow. More time exposed into equity will help us grow more. Then you eventually get the maturity amount at the time of maturity also, which was the eventual goal which you wanted to achieve.
Mr. Deepen has a specific question. His son is 9 months old and he's looking to invest in a single premium policy for about 15 years of policy term. His question is if that will he have to switch funds according to market, or can insurer also take care of that? So if you can talk about the investment strategies that we have, and maybe should he go for a single premium or a regular premium plan? I think
best feature about unit policies are these plans have various funds. What happens is you will have multi-cap funds, you would have large cap funds, and you would have mid-cap funds. It would completely depend upon what parallel savings do you have and your risk appetite. If you have a high risk appetite and you have backed yourself up, you have backed this investment up with other savings in the background, you should go for a high exposed equity product, because it will allow you to grow your money. And about in 5 years, you would be investing money for 15 years, every 5 years you can always switch some part of it, some part which has grown towards debt securities. That is the whole beauty of ULIPs and child ULIPs, and the edge that they hold over other instruments like maybe mutual funds or other SIPs. If you go for a one-time plan, your life cover continues to suffer, and if you go for a regular investment plan, you will be able to enjoy the benefits of 10 times of your life cover plus also income benefits. Now, since you are doing this for your child, then it becomes all the more necessary that your coverage is apt, not only in terms of the total life cover, plus God forbid if something happens, the income that your child should get, 1% of your sum assured, also becomes important, because that will help the child meet day-to-day or month-on-month expenses. There are stipulated strategies where from time to time the fund managers will continue shifting some growth money, some part of your growth amount into debt instruments. It is very simple. The money at stake that you put at the time of inception is always low. As in when your money grows into folds, that is when you will be all the more worried. And that is exactly how the whole concept works, that slowly and gradually the gradual growth that you have to make on your investment amount should get secured. And that is done by gradual movement in a systematic way from equity to debt, so that eventually your money stays safe.
Can we come to question number 8 here by Priya Karunakar? She says, I have two daughters, 13 years and 8 years old. What should be the ideal portfolio for me? What amount should I invest in to get the best returns when they turn 18?
So for your elder daughter, if you actually see, I'm sure you would have made some other savings and investments. However, you still have about a 5-year pay term and a 10-year policy term to choose, where there are options to make partial withdrawals. So the daughter that is about 13 years, if you continue paying for 5 years, there will be some corpus that you will get at the time of when she turns 18. If that is required, which could be utilized from a partial withdrawal from the equity variant of the child plan. Otherwise, you can continue to let it grow and take the entire maturity proceeds once she turns 23. That would primarily be between the life milestones of life of either higher education, which is post graduation, or her marriage. For the child which is 8 years, you still have about 10 years to save money and build a corpus for her graduation at the age of 18 and her post graduation at the age of 22 or 23. This is one. Second, when it comes to amount, it will also depend upon what exactly is your requirement in terms of when you see, do you require the money at the age of 18 for graduation, or does it only depend upon her for her wedding or for her higher education? You can always look upon a decent investment amount of 25k for the younger one and about 35 to 40k a month for the elder one. This will help you build a corpus, because yes, we'll have to agree that there are some years that you have missed out on investing the amount, because this is the only amount that would help you build a decent corpus, touching almost helping you meet the expenses that would be required, that you will have to eventually meet once both the daughters turn 18.
But Kushagra, I would like to ask you one question. How early can one start planning for their children, before they are born, or for parents who are planning, or maybe some days, few 90 days, or is there a timeline on that you should keep in mind?
There are parents who come in looking for plans once their spouse is expecting down in the 6 months, 7 months. You can start investing. There has to be, the child has to be there. So the child should have taken birth, and 30 days thereon, you can always go and take a plan on the child's name. Also, if we have any young couples who are yet to plan their family, what you can very easily do is the husband or the wife, either if both are working, can apply a plan as a proposer and life assured. Choose the other partner as the nominee. And once you plan a family and have a child, you can always add the child as a nominee, which also is one of the options available. This option is also liked by a lot of people because they can proudly say that they had planned their child's saving even before the child was born.
So there's another question that I see coming in. It says, is there any plan with income starting sooner than 5 years?
So actually this is something that a lot of customers had been asking over the years, and ICICI Prudential has actually come up with a very, very unique proposition in the last 3-4 months, wherein you can, and we had actually kind of mentioned one example in the slide. Basically, suppose if you're starting to invest 5 lakh rupees a year, right from second year onwards, you will start getting 1,25,000, roughly 25% of the premium that you're paying as income, and this income will continue for the next 10 years. So people who are looking to invest, and apart from this, after 10 years, you will start getting a larger income after your premium paying term is over. So basically, if you're paying say 5 lakh rupees for 10 years, from second year to 11th year, you're getting about 1,25,000 roughly. And from the 12th year, you'll be getting about, I think about 7.5 lakh rupees every year. So how that can help is basically the early income option can help you pay for the regular expenses, maybe school fees or any other expenses. And the higher income that you're getting after the 11th year can help you pay for the college fees. So very, very interesting option. So in the guaranteed section of Apeksha, I think people should definitely look at very, very different options. You have early income options, you have lump sum options, you have long-term income options. So a lot of options, and especially for our NRI viewers. See, interest rates in all over the world are very, very low now. And I think, I'm sure people, our friends here will be experiencing that MTs will be giving returns as low as 2% in Middle East or UK, US. And while in India, still you get about 6% guaranteed return, which is a very, very big difference versus the 2% that you get in outside India, right, in more developed nations. So I think that is why what we are also seeing is there is a lot of traction around guaranteed plans, and we have different types of plans available with us on our platform, which people can come and compare.
Absolutely. We have a lot of plans on our platform. We can obviously come and you can actually write into us on the ID that we shared, and we'll assist you with the details of the plans. And we're almost towards the end of the session, but before we end, I'll just quickly request, if in case anyone most of your queries is not answered, has gone unanswered, please post it in the Q&A section below. We'll still take them quickly before we wrap up. We have another question coming in from Rajiv Lal. He says, my son is 9 years old and daughter is 5, and they are Thai national residents. Can I invest in plans in India?
As a parent, yes, you can apply. Also, despite your children being Thai nationals, they still belong to the category of PIO, where they are a person of Indian origin. Eventually, if your father or your mother is an Indian and they ever held an Indian passport or Indian nationality, yes, you can apply for that. And later, at a later stage, you can also apply for an overseas citizenship of India while they being Thai nationals. and hold dual citizenship also. This is one. And here what will happen is the life assured and the proposer will be, sir who had asked this question, and they can always choose the nominee as their children for both of them.
Also, I have a question from Mr. Reddy here. What is, Kush, if I may ask, up to what age should one ideally invest in child plans for better returns?
No right start age. The day you wake up, you can invest, but you always know the end date. There will come a time where your child will no longer be a child. The day the child turns 18, the child becomes a major. That is one. You cannot still leave the hand of the child, because you will still have to take care of expenses up till graduation. Or as a parent, and this I tell to a lot of my customers, a parent would not think twice before shelling out the last penny if they had saved for their retirement when it comes to their children. Early, as the young couples who are yet to become parents, or even if you have become parents, you would be able to relate to what I'm trying to say. I have seen this. My parents did it for me, and I'm sure a lot of you would have also been through the same journey. As a father, as a mother, as parenthood being an aspect, parents do not shy out. Parents do not think twice of shelling out the last penny before they spend on their child. So the deadline is fixed. You will eventually have to meet these expenses at the age of 18 and 22 and 24, which is either graduation, post-graduation and wedding. So any day you decide, just go for it.
Vivek, coming to you, as you were talking about the income plans, there are some follow-up questions on them. They say, any guaranteed option to get returns after 20 years? If you can explain more details on, how many years will we get the return? What is the time span?
Supposing you're paying for 10 years, okay, and you're paying say 5 lakh rupees every year, what that plan gives you is, and that plan is specifically the ICICI guaranteed income for tomorrow, which gives you an early income option. So from second year onwards, you will start getting some income. And which is typically around 25% of the premiums that you're paying, and it can vary depending on the age. So I'm just saying, giving a rough estimate. So you'll get about 1,25,000 per year for the next 10 years. And from the 12th year till 21st year, you will get about roughly 7.5 lakh rupees, which is the higher income once your premium paying term is over. So this is when you're paying for 10 years, you basically can take care of both the school expenses and the college expenses. And coming back to the picture, the earlier question that is there a plan which can give you guaranteed lump sum after 20 years? Yes, there are many good options, and they have good IRRs in the range of 5.8 to 6%. There is a plan from Bajaj Allianz Gold Suraksha and Aditya Birla Guaranteed Milestone Plan. Both of them have a 10-year pay and 20-year stay option, where you can pay for 10 years. And after 20 years, you will get a lump sum amount. So people who are looking at investing really early, they can look at these guaranteed options. And these all of these give very, very good returns in the range of 5.5 to 6%. Which given these are not guaranteed returns, these are very, very good compared to what we get outside India. There is one more question from Mr. Srivastav and Kushagra. You can answer that. What are the major documents that are required for an NRI to get his policy issued?
So very basic KYC is required, where you can give your passport as your photo ID proof, your address proof, one employment certificate or your income proof may be required, only if provided you go for a very higher amount, above 5 lakh rupees. There's a FATCA and an NRI questionnaire in between the journey, where a basic question about travel and other place where you work, place where you stay is asked. Which we eventually take care of. We eventually help our customers fill in the questionnaires and help them upload them on the website or on the Policy Bazaar portal, which eventually gets pushed to any of the insurers via the API, and the plan gets issued. That is exactly where our role comes into the picture, making the whole process hassle-free and seamless, and giving you a good customer experience.
Before we end, Kush, I would want you to take us through some of the quick plan names. I know you've briefed us on what are the different kind of child plans one can invest in, but at our end, I would like you to quickly take the viewers through some of the quick best plans. For example, HDFC's Click to Wealth Child, Bajaj's Future Gain, Edelweiss Tokyo's, there are a few plans, right? So just quickly take us through and brush up through the best top five plans that one should look for.
So the slides that we had run through had the equity and market-based plans, had capital guarantee plans, and had guaranteed plans. So from the equity segment, we have plans from Bajaj, named as SWG, like you rightly said, HDFC, Click to Wealth Child variant. We have plans from Edelweiss Tokyo, which is the Wealth Plus plan. And then we have capital guarantee from each one of these, where we have Bajaj Child plan, we have HDFC. We also have a plan from Max Life, both in the equity segment and in the capital guarantee segment. Moving to the guaranteed segment, rightly said, we have been speaking a lot about the guaranteed income for tomorrow. That stands for GIFT from ICICI. And we have other plans that can be used as child plans from HDFC and from Max Life.
All right. So these are some quick top plans that Kushagra has just taken us through. Everyone out here, please quickly, maybe you can note it down, or you can mail us, or you can go onto our site to check these plans. All details with brochures and every detail will be there on our platform, and you can mail it to us on the ID policybazaarshow@policybazaar.com. In case you're not sure or you may not be able to understand on any specifics, our team is going to assist you and help you in buying. So I hope we deliver the best services and everything. Thank you everyone for tuning in, and we will be soon hosting another session for you guys and the audience here specifically. So we'll come back to you on that, and our promotions, keep watching our Policy Bazaar space. And thank you all for joining in. Thank you everyone.